cries are almost pleas now. Christian Beam, the president of the French Federation. Delighted, of course, that Cédric Pioline has come through. Hedberg then 1-4. Love two in sets. Really tapped that forehand. Nothing's working now, and for the first time he's not playing well at all. What a shame. He's helped light up this tournament in the first week with some breathtaking displays, rolling back the years, playing better than ever. What would he give for some of that form right now? Oh, that'll do as a start.
No, like the whole point. The serve up the center line to the forehand, and pretty good backhand volley. Great running forehand volley for the winner. He'd have just waited one more shot. You know, he played the backhand down the line, which I go along with. Dangerous to come in behind it, though. If he'd have waited for the forehand to go wherever he wants to hit it and then attack the backhand.
No game is safe. Super ground strokes from Rossi. It really has been an excellent performance from the Swiss. Oh, oh. And that might finish it. When you get hit by a Rossi forehand, you stay
hit.
That's
gotta hurt. Boy. Or at least sting.
Even in slow motion, it moves. But he's got to get up, wipe himself down and get back to business, because another big point. Second chance for a break here for Rossi. Again, the return set it up.
Well, he's unlucky because he anticipated that the forehand would be an off forehand. But it wasn't an off forehand. It was straight up the center forehand. So his racket was coming back to hit the backhand. He was ready for a backhand volley.
Well, the standard of Edberg's play has really picked up again in this game. But is it too late? This is what the crowd want, and now they're inspired. And at the 12th hour, can the crowd and Edberg turn this around? Listen to it go now. should have made it.
Well, he should have put the forehand volley away. And there he's practicing the forehand volley again. This one coming up now. He just got it a little bit too late. Couldn't get the angle that he was looking for and had to scramble for the backhand.
And that's the penalty. And another break point for Mark Rossi. This for 5-1. He'd be serving for the match if he gets it with a 2-break advantage. That, I'm afraid, is all she wrote. Against a normal guy, it would be tough, but against Mark Rossi, it's too tough.
One can be a little bit disappointed in what we've seen today from Ed Berg, but he's got to hold his head up high. He's had a pretty good tournament. He hasn't had the greatest of draws, and he's come through with flying colours. He's just up against a guy that's playing superbly well.
Rossi then serving for a place in his first Grand Slam quarterfinal. And maybe he might wobble. Perhaps he's seen the finishing line.
Oh, that just shot right through the line.
Too good, as he has been through this match. Now, well played.
He's going to go down fighting. The drop shot, approach shot. It's very well executed.
So, break point to try and save one of these 2 breaks. He's down. But there's the equalizer in so many ways. Oh, one of the few times he's played the hook.
Pretty good time to play one as well, because Edberg was leaning to the left.
So after a minute over 2 hours. Set point, match point. This for Rosé for his first Grand Slam quarterfinal. Woof.
Rosé hesitated twice then. First off, after the return of serve, giving the impression he thought that the return might go into the net. And then he came into the net, and then he was very late in moving towards that backhand volley.
Still, he's not out of it. The old timer just doesn't want to leave center stage. Oh, it's net. Can't see it, but you have to believe the guy who has the finger on the tape. Don't you, Bob?
I do, always. Oh, he was going for a very big one that time.
Well played. Someone up there, I think, is upsetting Marc Rosé. But maybe he's upsetting himself a little bit there. It's 5-2.
For the perfect meal every time, all you need is a generous helping of Bordeaux. Just open, pour, and enjoy immediately. Pasta with a dash of Bordeaux.
And savoir-faire of a region, the balance of a prestigious wine, Malzin Bordeaux, first in France.
Is it just one last hurrah, or is there a meaningful switch? Rosé wobbling, Edberg still in this. 2-5. Surely not. It's his first break of the Rosé serve since the opening game. Now the crowd not helping, and not helping Edberg.
I don't know why they're doing it. I guess they have to assume that they're being funny. I can't imagine that anybody else thinks that they're funny.
Yes.
One of the few times he's gone there.
Yes. Well, we've seen it a couple of times now in the last 10 minutes, but for a couple of hours, it was all across. Mm-hmm. Once again, Rosé moves to within 2 points of the match. Oh, a mighty shot.
It's amazing he never misses his forehand. You know, it's he doesn't always give the impression that he's middled the ball on the strings, yet it seems to be there's a radar there or something that's pulling that ball in. It really is a superb forehand.
Three more match points.
I'm surprised the let judge heard the call with all the yelling. Must have felt that one.
Roland Herfeld trying to keep some calm here. Well played.
That first volley was outstanding on the forehand side.
He just won't lie down. Yes.
If he could get out of this game, the next game could be very interesting.
Because Rossi just did wobble a little on the last service game. Three match points saved. He's the third in this game, the fourth overall. First one he's missed. He stood up and asked to be punished. And now the Swiss are a little worried.
It seems like the Swiss supporters there, Jakob Lasek, and that about the only people that are supporting Rossi. Everybody else around them cheering for Edberg. Well, he got out of it.
Wonderful atmosphere now. And if Edberg could win the next game, it would be tough for Rossi. Just listen to this. No one knows Mark Rossi better than Jakob Lasek, giving him a steely look as he serves for the second time for the match.
Hedberg means business. What he did in the first game of the match has done very seldom since then, at least on a consistent basis.
So the doubts are re-emphasized.
Good serve.
Thought it was a let. No problem. He's cutting it fine. Didn't want to go over. Clever change from Rossi, going down that forehand wing. edging closer again.
A little bit short, perhaps, the approach shot. And that was very nearly over the net.
Been a match short of drama until the last 10 minutes, and now it's a cauldron of noise.
It's exciting stuff. What Mark needs here, two good first serves. Doesn't want Edberg to attack him. Missed it.
And he's hardly missed one all match. Break point for Edberg. But it was pretty emphatic. His eighth ace.
Outstanding stuff.
No. What a shame after making the return off a blitzed 199 deep. And true, and he got it back. And then he makes that. Match point number five. At last, very well played. You can imagine how difficult it was for him. Rosset's through. And a night to celebrate tonight. And the end of an era here at Roland Garros on this new court. Stefan Edberg waves goodbye. Rosset going up to coach Stefan over at a big win for him. And the crowd getting ready to say their goodbyes to this wonderful man called Stefan Edberg. His biggest achievement so far, Marc Rosset, was winning the Olympic title in Barcelona. But that was as good a win as he's had. And good to see him add his goodbye to Stefan. They love style here in Paris. And there's no greater stylist than this man.
Well, it's never easy to say goodbye, is it? It's a very, very difficult thing, especially someone like Stefan, who's so admired all over the world. Great player, great person. Really is very, very sad. But it happens to every sports person. Eventually they have to say goodbye, because he'll be saying goodbye a lot this year, but it doesn't make it any easier. Perhaps in some respects, makes it a little bit more difficult each and every time he has to do that. That is a good performance by Marc Rosset to have come through that match 7-6, 6-3, 6-3. Had all the pressure on him. And he was absolutely relieved at the end. He went to say thank you to his coach. And that's good to see. So often you see players winning and they say, well, you know, I was brilliant, blah, 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 blah. And then when they lose, it's the poor old coach's fault. But he's prepared to share with the coach, share with his opponent there, the stupidity of missing that one forehand that he missed.
Rosset with Nelson Montfort.
Je dirais avec plein d'émotions avec Stéphane Marc, tellement d'émotions que vous l'avez applaudi
vous-même
à la fin.
There was so much emotion in that match.
Au-delà du résultat, beaucoup de respect pour ce joueur.
Realize you have a lot of respect for that player.
He has a lot of respect for Stéphane Marc.
Yes.
C'est bizarre, j'avais dit avec des amis que ce serait son dernier match à Roland Garros aujourd'hui.
Some friends of mine told me it would be his last match at the French Open. Well, I'm glad I won, but I'm also sorry for him.
He knew it was the last match for Stéphane Roland Garros, saying he's glad he won, but he's sorry.
I was not aware of what he'd done in his life, but it's really fantastic.
Vous avez affronté aujourd'hui donc Stéphane pour son dernier Roland Garros, et surtout, c'est la première fois que vous réussissez aussi bien dans un tournoi du Grand Chelem. Alors là, je dirais que vous allez avoir plein de sentiments qui se mélangent dans votre tête.
This is the first time that Marc's done so well in a Grand Slam. Mixed feelings because of Stefan's defeat. Marc saying yes, he's been waiting for this kind of success for a really long time, and saying that a lot of his friends have been waiting for a long time as well.
Everything is going well this week. I've been playing for 2 weeks.
Things have been going really well this week.
I'm feeling well, and I hope it will go well.
His head's okay.
Well, Marc, we hope everything will be all right for you.
I have a feeling, actually, at the end of the match,
presque un peu triste pour Stéphane. C'est pour ça que je parle de sentiments.
Nelson saying that at the end of the match he had a feeling that Marc was almost sorry for Stéphane.
Je voulais quitter le terrain le plus vite possible.
I wanted to leave the court as soon as possible, to leave him with the public, with the crowd, because I think
Marc saying he wanted to leave the court for as quick as he could, to leave Stéphane with his public, because he is a great champion.
Once he leaves the circuit, we shall realize how much we miss him.
Once Stéphane leaves the circuit, everyone will realize how much he'll be missed. That's how he finished it. A big ace, his ninth. And the Swiss are so glad he did it.
He's in the quarters, and who's to say he can't go all the way?
Right then. He'll play either Bernd Karbacher or Goran Ivanišević. That match is over. Won't give you the result. It's coming up later on with David Mercer and Fru McMillan. Bring out 12.